Now I would like to introduce my good friend Ashaz. Ashaz is an 11-year-old boy going to 6th grade. He is an avid reader and plans to pursue his interest in Lego building by taking up robotic engineering. His hobbies include playing soccer, basketball, video games, and riding on his bike. Please welcome my good friend Ashaz.
Hi everyone, my name is Ashaz Chowdhury. Today I'll be talking about Steve Jobs. First of all, can everyone hear me?
Yep.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to thank Shrise for his speech on video games and sports, as well as for introducing me. I learned a lot about the benefits and disadvantages of each. So I'll be splitting my topic into three parts. One, who Steve Jobs was. Two, his early life. And three, his career. Let's begin. Steve Jobs was the co-founder of Apple. You may have heard of the company because it's one of the leading technology companies. He started the company with Steve Wozniak in 1976, but actually left the company in 1985 and returned more than a decade later. He also, for some time, was the owner of Pixar, or animation studios, as well as starting a company called Next Inc. But let's talk about that later. So now let's talk about his early life. Steve was born in 1955 to a Syrian immigrant and an American woman. They had to give him up for adoption because, as the woman's parents wouldn't originally let her marry an Arab, they had to. He was adopted by Paul and Clara Jobs, who lived in Mountain View, California, in the area later known as Silicon Valley. He learned to take apart and reconstruct electronics in the family garage with his father, and from the start, he was an innovative and smart thinker. But his early life was riddled with frustration due to formal schooling. And in elementary school, he became a prankster due to boredom, and his teacher had to bribe him to study in fourth grade. Imagine that, your teacher paying you, having to pay you to study. That must be the life. But even though he was a prankster and he had to be bribed to study, he tested so well that administrators wanted to skip him ahead to high school. But his parents declined the offer. They wanted him to go through his actual schooling before actually getting to high school. When he was enrolled at Homestuck High School, he met his future partner, Steve Wozniak. Wozniak was enrolled at the University of California in Berkeley. After high school, Jobs went to Reed College, but dropped out after 6 months lacking direction. And he spent the next 18 months dropping in on creative classes. It was just to learn. And he later recalled how one specific course in calligraphy developed his love for typography. Now let's talk about Steve Jobs' career. After college, Steve became a video game designer at the company Atari. You may have heard of it, because it actually created Pac-Man, Miss Pac-Man, and probably a lot of other Pac-Man games. But he soon left the company because he wanted to find enlightenment in India. In 1976, he and Wozniak started Apple Computer in the Jobs family garage. They originally marketed the Apple I for $666.66. I wonder what their favorite number was.
Five.
As a young man in the said, hit five. No, that's incorrect. Yes?
Nine.
As the young man said, nine. No, that is also incorrect. Their favorite number was six. Who would have thought? Anyways. That first computer earned the corporation $774,000. Compared to nowadays, it's not really that much. But 3 years after the Apple II was released, the sales increased by 700% at $139 million. Soon, Jobs looked to marketing expert John Sculley of Pepsi Cola to become the CEO of Apple. Even though Apple was doing great, its next few products had major flaws, and Sculley began to believe that Jobs was hurting Apple. And because he had no official title with the company, the executives began to phase him out, and he was put in a more insignificant position. He soon, being a smart person, grasped that they were starting to make him less important. Let's say that. He left the company to start a hardware and software company called Next Inc. Capital N, lowercase e, and capital X and capital T. The next year, he bought an animation studio from George Lucas, which later came to be known as Pixar Animation Studios, and produced wildly popular films such as Toy Story and Finding Nemo. I guess you could say Steve had an animated life.
Yes, truly.
But even though Pixar was having a lot of success, Next was just completely failing. Its several attempts to sell its specialized operating system to the country were not working. And soon Apple bought the company, and Steve returned to his original post as Apple CEO. After many changes, such as a new design team, and a self-imposed salary for Steve at $1 a year, Steve put Apple back on track. He made several ingenious products, such as the iMac, otherwise known as the Mac, which is actually short for Macintosh, which you can sort of get from the company's name being Apple. Anyways, after that, the company was doing very well. But in 2003, Steve discovered he had pancreatic cancer. He decided to postpone surgery and alter his pesco vegetarian diet, as well as looking for Eastern remedies. But after 9 months, he had a successful surgery. But in 2009, he began losing weight, and I don't mean in a good way, not like muscles, everything. I mean like, you can see his ribs. You could probably see his ribs, so people thought his health problems had come back, which included a liver transplant. And on October 5th, 2011, Apple announced that its co-founder had died. The great Steve Jobs was gone. He was 56 years old. Today, I talked about 1, who Steve Jobs was, 2, his early life, and 3, his career. Steve once said, "Being the richest man in the cemetery doesn't matter to me. Going to bed at night saying you've done something wonderful, that's what matters to me." And I believe he did do something wonderful. I believe he changed the world. On that sad note, I'd like to conclude my speech. I hope you all enjoyed, and thank you for listening.